So Vergil, you made weight, you're ready to fight. What are you eating now to rehydrate?
I just had some orange juice, I had a Powerade, had some water. He let me have his pancake, so I had a slice of pancake.
You feel good, you look good, you're ready.
I'm good, yeah, I'm real good, yeah.
You and DeNorma talked on the way back from the morning weigh-in, what did you say?
A little bit, I mean, short talk, you know, how you doing, good morning, that's it. I don't got too much to say to him.
The whole world's tuning into this fight, because after you take care of business, which I'm sure you will, all respect to Thomas, they don't be disrespectful. You and Tim Zhu in August, they already announced it for a title intro.
Yeah, yeah. Hopefully, you know, we're not looking past anyone.
Never.
We're going to take care of business on Saturday. But, yeah, hopefully. We're really hoping for that fight.
No. Jose, how are you feeling? How was the weigh-in?
I'm good, Ellie. I'm good. It's the weigh-in in the morning.
What are we eating to get rid of, to get back in our weight?
Well, I got some eggs, hash browns, potatoes. And then pancakes.
And you get to sleep in your own bed?
Yeah.
That's cool. But how are you feeling? Good?
I'm feeling good, man. I'm feeling really good.
Did you see Rancis at all?
Yeah, but we've seen him in the morning, yeah.
How is he looking?
Yeah, man. I wasn't paying too much attention, but I'm ready. That's all I know, Eddie. I'm ready for this. For this Saturday night for 27th. And then stay on track to... look for those big fights, you know?
You and Haney has to happen. I want to see that. Him and Haney for the belt?
For the belt, not. Hey, man, Ryan Garcia in the catchweight, you know? I'm kind of like, we made this fight 142. Max, I got a call 3 days ago that the Rancis promoter was asking if the fight could be at 142, 141. And I said, yeah, let's make it at 142, you know. Just
to make it happen. You just want to fight, yeah.
I just want to fight. And plus, there's no money. You know, if he comes over, there's no money. And if I was to come over, you know, I would have to pay him money, you know. So I figured, yeah, let's do it at 142, and I kind of like it.
Okay, yeah, you're the first guy to call out Ryan Garcia, because he's called out the whole world. He called out Earl, he called out this, he called out Tank, he called out Fondora. But you're calling him out. You want to fight him next.
Yeah, you know, why not?
Easy to make. Both were golden.
Yeah, you know,
no problem.
I like his class at 144, 145.
I like it.
You know, I think it'll be a huge fight in September for, you know, Mexican Independence Weekend here in LA. You know, definitely sell out.
Very nice of you to donate almost $70,000 worth of tickets to Six Boys and Girls Club here.
Yeah, yeah. No, we gotta make sure we keep the boys. Motivated and encouraged, you know, encourage them to see what's out there, you know, and to see through the sports and through the entertainment, you know, for them to get motivated, you know, so when they go back, because a lot of these guys are talented, you know, these young kids are 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 year olds, and they're real talented when it comes to sports, you know, they just have to, you know, be guided on the discipline and things like that, but... Yeah, and I'm happy to do that, and you know, to help also the Lymphoma Society for the cancer, you know. So we gave a little block of tickets for them to sell, because there's this like there's this deal where there's a bunch of little small groups of people that they challenge each other to see who raises the most money for cancer, and put out together. It's a bunch of kids, a bunch of young guys,
that's amazing.
Young guys and young women from high school, and they raised $635,000
in
6 weeks, so we're helping to add some tickets, you know, to help them, you know, get more funds and things like that, so, you know, they were able to sell their tickets, and we also gave tickets to, like, this nonprofit, and they sold all of them. They sold over $200,000 worth of tickets.
Is it fight sold?
Some of them was going to... Yeah, actually, this morning when I walked in, they're like, everything's sold out. It was probably about, you know, it's 15,000 plus seats in the arena. And the rest that are probably left are scattered. And it's probably like, I don't know, like 400 tickets scattered left. But once you go past a certain mark, it's considered sold out. And it's sold out.
Well, congratulations. Another sellout. I didn't doubt it.
Yeah, man. Like 50,000, you know, 50,000 people is not hard to bring, even if you get 50 tickets.
Not easy.
No, so our, obviously, you know, our gate doesn't, the prices are not priced, you know, like the other bigger fights out there. But I guarantee you, if I was to face, you know, like a Devin Haney or Ryan Garcia.
Yeah, we're going to go.
I would make the tickets obviously price higher and everything stuff.
Oh well, when you fight Ryan, it's gonna break records. But we'll see you in about an hour. The public weigh-in. Good seeing you guys. Charles, good seeing you. I'm gonna head out. We'll be back. Thanks, Jose. Love being in Fresno. It's the place to be. The most popular guy in town. At least I'm back reporting. Ellie Sekback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.